Good morning, everyone. Welcome to today's webinar session. Children, today's topic is about ellipse, which will be dealt by Mrs. Sri V. Ushasri Madam, PGT Mathematics, TSMS Velimala, RCpuram. Already, Madam is very familiar to you, children. She has taught three chapters in 2A, Mathematics 2A. She is having an experience of 20 years and above. Very hardworking teacher. And also, she is very enthusiastic to learn new things. So, Madam, over to you.
Thank you, Madam. Dear children, I welcome you all to our next topic, that is ellipse. As Madam was telling, I am very familiar to you people, right? The topic ellipse, which we are dealing with, is a topic in 2B. Okay. When I say ellipse, it is not a new word, children. You are very familiar with this word. Now, I'm sure when I say ellipse, you will recollect your physics topics, what you have learned in your first year. Kepler's laws of gravitation. Isn't it? They were totally based on elliptical motion of objects. That means when I mention Kepler's laws, I'm very sure that you will understand it's a practical concept what we are dealing with. Okay. It has got its vast applications in physics also. Okay. So let us get into the depth of the topic, ellipse. Now today, we are going to learn what is a conic, focus, directrix, eccentricity, chord, what is a focal chord, latus rectum, major axis and minor axis. See, all these terms, few terms you are familiar with because you have completed the topic parabola. But still, I feel that you can recollect when we discuss these topics. Then we'll see what is the standard form of an ellipse and how the curve, nature of the curve will be. We will also see the various forms of ellipse. Now, coming to the first definition, conic. What is a conic? See, children, you have studied about conic when you have started with parabola, isn't it? It is a locus or set of points in the plane whose distances from a fixed point, it bears a constant ratio to their corresponding perpendicular distance from a fixed straight line. It is a cone. It is a conic, right? Conic is what? It is a set of points, or we can say it is locus, which satisfies certain condition. What is that condition? Distances from a fixed point will have a constant ratio to the corresponding perpendicular distance from a fixed straight line. Okay, this is what we have seen in parabola concept also. Now, when I say fixed point and a fixed straight line, what is this fixed point and fixed straight line? Now, when you take an axis, you just take a fixed point S. Then let us take a line L, which is a fixed straight line. We will take a point, P on a conic. Let us assume that the point P is on a conic. That conic can be anything. It can be a parabola. It can be an ellipse. It can be a hyperbola too. Okay. Now, PM is the perpendicular drawn to the line L. We are dropping a perpendicular from point P onto this fixed straight line. Then we are joining S and P also. SP is the distance between the fixed point and the point on the conic. PM is nothing but the perpendicular distance which we are taking from the point onto the straight line. Okay. Then the locus of P, such that SP by PM is a constant, is nothing but a conic. Now this constant what we are taking, we will call it as E. We will name it as E. The fixed point S, we call it as focus. The fixed line onto which we are dropping the perpendicular, we call it as directrix of the conic. Then SP by PM is equal to some constant, isn't it? That constant we are calling it as eccentricity, and we represent that with the letter E. Now, depending on the value of E, we try to define different conics. Now, you are very familiar with parabola. In parabola also, SP by PM equal to E formula you have seen. There, you have taken E is equal to 1. When eccentricity is equal to 1, you called it as a parabola. But today, I will try to give you what exactly, how the value of E is defining different geometrical figures. If E is equal to 0, then the conic becomes a circle. How? We will look into that. If E is equal to 1, then the conic becomes a parabola. This you have already learned. Now, today we are going to see E less than 1, then we call it as an ellipse. E less than 1 case we will see today. Okay, and we also have E greater than 1, then we call it as a hyperbola. This hyperbola concept also we will deal after ellipse. Now, SP by PM is equal to E. When we were talking about a circle, when we were discussing the properties or the concept circle, we never mentioned E equal to 0, but E is 0 there. SP is equal to SP is equal to E into PM. When E is equal to 0, SP becomes 0. That fixed point what we are taking in a circle will be the center of the circle. You can just try it out and try to get the equation by taking any point on the circle. You call it as some X, Y and center. You take a point and just try it out. E equal to 0 works out. So we can also say circle is also a conic. Okay. And then the straight line passing through the focus and it is and perpendicular to the directrix, then we call it as axis of the ellipse. Okay, children, having seen these definitions, the basic concepts what are required for a conic, we will get into the standard form of an ellipse. Like how you have seen the standard form of a circle, of a parabola, we will also see what is the standard form of an ellipse. Now, we are taking the axis, x and y axis, with center 0, 0. Just taking an ellipse. And we are taking a point A on the ellipse with the coordinates a, 0. You can just observe, children, where is A? A is on x-axis. On x-axis, y coordinate will be 0. Isn't it? So I hope that you have observed it, right? And likewise, you have A dash. A dash is minus A, 0. Then we will take the fixed points S and S dash. As I was mentioning, S is the fixed point, which we call it as focus. For an ellipse, we have two foci, right, children? So two foci and one center. Two vertices on one of the axes, and another two vertices also will have on another axis, right? Well, we will define certain terms for what type of axis you have, major and minor axis. At that time, we'll get into the details of it. Now, we are taking a point Z through which a line is passing. This line, what we are calling it as a fixed line. Is the directrix, okay? And on the other side also, through Z dash, a line is passing. This is again a directrix on the other side of the center, right? Now, try to observe this carefully. When I say SP by PM, what is P? P is a point on the conic. Now, the point can be anywhere, isn't it? It is an arbitrary point. At random, we are picking a point on the conic. Now, ellipse is a conic. So I can pick up the point anywhere on the ellipse. Now here we are choosing a point which is there on the x-axis. Okay. Now can I say A dash Z is a perpendicular distance? Yes, definitely. It is a perpendicular dropped onto the vertex. And likewise, A Z is also a perpendicular dropped from the point onto the fixed line that we are calling it as directrix. Okay. Now, as the formula says, SP by PM is a constant. Here, the value of P is nothing but A in our diagram, right? So I can definitely say SA by AZ is equal to E. Our point P here at this particular, in this diagram, as I was mentioning, I am naming it as A. See, I just wanted to show you the point name can be anything. The point can be anywhere on the coning. That's the reason why I have picked up a point A, which is bearing the coordinates A, 0. So SA by AZ is equal to E. Just go for cross multiplication, children. Then you will have it as SA is equal to E into AZ. Now let us see where is this AZ. A to Z. Observe this. A to Z. Right? And this further, you can write it as AZ is nothing but CZ minus CA. CZ is the distance from C to Z. From C to Z, look at the distance. From this, if I can remove C to A, then I will be left with AZ. Okay. So instead of AZ, we can always replace it as CZ minus CA. Likewise, we will go to the other side of the axis and we will say SA dash by A dash Z, which is equal to E. SA dash. S is a fixed point. And A dash is a point on the conic. So SA dash by A dash Z, A dash Z. From A dash, you're dropping the perpendicular till here. Just observe this. Okay. Now, if you go for cross multiplication, then you will have it as SA dash is equal to E into A dash Z. Now, A dash Z, observe this. A dash is here. Z is a point here. Then A dash Z can be calculated by taking CZ, observe this, C to Z plus C to A dash, isn't it? So I can replace A dash Z with CZ plus C A dash. Now, what is CA? Just look at this, CA. C is a point which we are calling it as center of the ellipse with the coordinate 0, 0. And A is a point which bears the coordinates A, 0. Then the length of the CA by distance formula, when you calculate it, will be A. Likewise, C to A dash is also A. Just calculate and see this see length is never negative, isn't it? That negative sign may be due to the opposition in the direction of the axis, but length is never negative, that you already know, right? So CA and CA dash, both are of equal length and the length of that is equal to A. So we can conclude saying CA is equal to A and CA dash is also equal to A. Now, we have calculated SA and SA dash and we got it as E into CZ minus CA, E into CZ plus CA dash. Now, we'll just continue with the calculation SA plus SA dash. So whatever we have calculated SA and SA dash, we are adding, children. Now, in both the terms, you have E. So E we will take common and we will just write CZ minus CA plus CZ plus CA dash. Now, just now we have concluded saying CA and CA dash have equal length. So we can cancel these two values, right? Both are small a and a. So minus a and plus a, they get canceled. Then SA plus SA dash, what it is, we will see. Now, this is what is the diagram, what we have seen in the previous slide. Now, observe this. SA, did you observe this orange line? SA is this. then SA dash. SA dash is from here to here. So totally it is giving you the length of AA dash. So instead of SA plus SA dash, we can always replace it as AA dash, which is equal to E into CZ plus CZ, it becomes 2CZ. You got it, right? Now, CA is small a, CA dash is again CA and CA dash, both are of equal length, A and A. So AA dash, when you say from here to here, it is A. From here to here, it is again A. So AA dash is equal to 2A. 2A is equal to 2E into CZ. So we can cancel 2 and 2. We can cancel 2 and 2 and we are left with A is equal to E into CZ. That means we can conclude saying CZ is equal to A by E. What is CZ? Let us observe. C to Z. C to Z. The length is A by E. That means we can take the coordinates of Z as A by E comma 0. A by E comma 0. See, when the length from here to here it is A, that means it is the point, coordinates of the point is A comma 0. Likewise, CZ, we are getting it as A by E. Therefore, coordinates of Z is nothing but A by E comma 0. Right? Therefore, we can say Z dash is minus A by E comma 0. That means it will be of equal length but opposition in direction. That's the reason why you're getting a negative sign over here. Therefore, we can conclude saying equation of the directrix is X is equal to A by E. Now, SA is nothing but, look at this. I want SA, children. So I can just take CA. From this CA, if you can subtract CS, then I will get SA. Therefore, we can say SA is equal to CA minus CS. This is equal to E into AZ, CA minus CS, CA minus CS. Right? So which is nothing but A in AZ. But what is AZ? AZ can also be taken as CZ minus CA is nothing but AZ. Now we'll call this as equation number one. Now let us see the same figure again. Now this time we are taking the center, the vertices, and also the foot of the perpendiculars, which we are dropping from the point to the fixed line, that is the directrix. Now, SA dash is nothing but CS. Observe the lines carefully, CS and CA dash. S from here, SA dash is nothing but C to S, this length, and C to A dash. Therefore, we can say S A dash is equal to C S plus C A dash. C S plus C A dash is nothing but A dash Z. Then A dash Z can also be replaced as C Z plus C A dash. This we have already seen in the previous slides. So we call it as equation number two. From equation one, we will subtract equation two. In equation one, we have CA minus CS, and here we are getting CS minus CA dash. Now, we will just expand this. This is equal to E into CZ minus CA minus CZ minus CA dash. Now, whatever terms possible, we'll try to cancel, children. We have seen previously CA and CA dash both are equal, so they get cancelled. Then you have CZ and minus CZ, they are getting cancelled. Then you are left with minus 2CS is equal to E into minus 2A. Therefore, we can conclude saying CS is equal to AE. CS is equal to AE. Where is the CS? This is CS. CS is AE. That means coordinates of S can be taken as AE comma 0 and S dash will be minus AE comma 0. Okay, so we got the coordinates of the focus also. So focus can be calculated with the formula AE comma 0 and minus AE comma 0 will be S dash. Right, so in the standard form we have calculated the foot of the perpendiculars, that is Z and Z dash. We have also seen what are the coordinates of the foci. Right, now at random we will pick up a point P x comma y on the ellipse, then according to the formula SP by PM is equal to E. So what is that you will get, children? We can also write it as SP is equal to E into PM. So that if you square, you will get it as SP square is equal to E square into PM square. Now we have the coordinates for S as AE comma 0. What is P? P is X comma Y. And what is M? M is what? M is A by E comma 0. That M is nothing but the foot of the perpendicular what you're getting. Isn't it? Now we will expand this by taking the formula for calculation of distance, x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square under root. So we will get it as, look at this. P is x comma y, m is a by e comma 0. So pm is equal to x minus a by e. And what is this sp? S is AE comma 0, P is X comma Y. So X minus AE whole square plus Y square. That under root will not be there because you're taking square. So this is equal to E square into X square plus A square by E square minus 2AX by E. We are just calculating this by taking the distance formula with these points. Okay. Then when you expand this, you will get it as X square plus a square e square minus 2x ae plus y square, which is equal to e square into x square plus e square a square by e square minus e square into 2ax by e. Now whichever terms are possible to cancel, we will cancel them, right? So we will be left with what? You will have it as x square plus a square e square minus 2x AE plus y square, which is equal to e square x square plus a square minus 2x AE. Okay, now still further. Now the same step what we have seen, we are carrying this. Now on either sides of equality, you have minus 2x AE. You can cancel them on both sides. When you do that, what are left? X square here and some x square term here. We will club together by taking this term to the left hand side. Then you will have it as x square into 1 minus e square. Now you have y square. We will write it as plus y square as it is. Now a square e square plus a square you have, isn't it? Now we will take this a square to the other side. Right, a square can be brought to the right hand side or this can be taken to the left hand side. It hardly matters. Then we will take a square common, right? So you can write it as a square into 1 minus e square. Look at this, children, you have a square and this minus a square e square, when you send this side, you will be left with plus a square only. All right, now we will divide both sides with a square into 1 minus e square. When we do that, we'll have it as x square into 1 minus e square by a square into 1 minus e square plus y square by a square into 1 minus e square, which is equal to a square into 1 minus e square by a square into 1 minus e square. Now you can cancel some terms which are same, right? Now these a square into 1 minus e square, they get cancelled. And here again, these two also get cancelled. You will be left with a square, x square by a square plus y square by a square into 1 minus e square is equal to 1. Now children, what is that we have taken the value for e, for an ellipse? E is less than 1. But can you have e equal to 0? You cannot have. Why? If e is equal to 0, then it becomes a circle, as we were discussing right in the beginning of the class, right? So this means that the value of e should lie between 0 and 1, right? So since your value of e is lying between 0 and 1, 1 minus e square is always greater than 0, right? E is a smaller value, less than 1, right? When you square it, it becomes still smaller. And 1 minus a smaller value, of course, it is a positive value. Smaller than 1, when you are subtracting, it will be greater than 0. Therefore, when you take a square into 1 minus e square, it is also greater than 0 because you are multiplying two positive values. Now, we will choose a real number b, which is greater than 0. Right? Such that a square into 1 minus e square is greater than 0. Therefore, we will replace this a square into 1 minus e square with b square. So we will write from now onwards, a square into 1 minus e square will be taken as b square. Now, when we replace this a square into 1 minus e square is equal to b square in the equation what we got just now, we will get it as x square by a square plus y square by b square is equal to 1, which is nothing but a standard ellipse equation. This is a standard ellipse equation. Right, children? So x square by a square plus y square by b square is equal to 1 is a standard ellipse equation. And for an ellipse, the value of eccentricity, that is e, will be always less than 1. But of course, it will be greater than 0. Now, quickly, we will see some definitions which you are familiar with. So what is a chord? Now, you are taking an ellipse, children. Of course, the ellipse has got two foci, S and S dash. Now, chord is what? Chord is a line. It is a line segment which joins any two points on the ellipse or any conic for that matter, right? So a line segment joining any two points on the ellipse is called the chord of an ellipse. Now the same definition we'll take for a circle and also a parabola, right? So chord can be like this, children. It is joining two points on the conic what we are taking as ellipse, okay? Now, what is a focal chord? What is a focal chord? It is also a chord, but it has got something, one extra property. What is it? It passes through the focus, right? A chord passing through one of the foci is called a focal chord, right? So you have a chord like this, but the speciality of this chord is it is passing through the focus, right? Now we have another definition, that is lattice rectum. Lattice rectum is a focal chord. Now observe this. In every definition what we are seeing, we are taking one extra property, right? When I said the chord is simply a line segment which is joining any two points on the ellipse. But when you talk of a focal chord, it is a chord, but it is passing through focus. Now when I say a lattice rectum is also a chord. The chord which passes through the focus, and that focal chord is perpendicular to the major axis of the ellipse. Okay, so lattice rectum is a focal chord which is perpendicular. See this? This chord is passing through the focus. It is passing through the focus and it is perpendicular to the major axis of the ellipse. Then we call it as lattice rectum. Now, children, I have shown you the lattice rectum for one focus, isn't it? But you have another focus also, S dash. So this can be taken for the other focus also. That means ellipse will have two lattice recta. Okay? It will have two lattice recta. But what is a lattice rectum? It is a focal chord perpendicular to the major axis of the ellipse. Now, having learned all this, we will quickly see what is the nature of the curve. Now, equation of the ellipse in standard form is what? Just now we have seen, isn't it? X square by a square plus y square by b square equal to 1. And here, when we do so, we will make sure that a is always greater than b. And of course, both the values a and b are greater than 0. From where you are getting this a and b, children? A and b are the length, the distance which we are measuring or which we are taking on the axis x and y. Or we can say axis of the ellipse. Okay. Now, we will call this as equation 1. From this equation 1, right, we can calculate x. How you are getting this as x? X square by a square is equal to, I can just send this term to the other side. When we do so, we will get it as 1 minus y square by b square. So once we get 1 minus y square by b square, if you simplify it, you will get b square minus y square by b square. Now send this a square to the other side. So it can be multiplied and take the root. So when you do that, you will get it as x is equal to plus or minus a by b root of b square minus y square. And likewise, you can also calculate y, which is nothing but plus or minus b by a root of a square minus x square. We will call this as equation number 2. Now, from equation number 2, clearly we can say x is real. How can we say if x is real, you should have b square minus y square should be greater than or equal to 0, because under the root, whatever you have, right, it should be greater than or equal to 0. For negative number, square root is not defined. Now, when b square minus y square is greater than or equal to 0, you can very well say the value of b is lying between minus b and b. That means mod y is less than or equal to b. Now, likewise, when you take y is real, it implies an implied if and only if, right? A square minus x square is greater than or equal to 0. This implies your x value, the value of x is lying between minus a and a. That means mod x is less than or equal to a. Now, clearly, x is taking a value which is equal to minus a and plus a, and y is taking the values as minus b and plus b. That means we can conclude saying that ellipse is symmetric about both the axes. What are both the axes, x and y axis? Here, for this particular ellipse, right, with center 0, 0. Now, we can also... We will just see this formula, children, what we have seen just now. We have deduced it from the standard ellipse equation. Y is equal to plus or minus b by a root of a square minus x square. Now, suppose if you take y is equal to 0, what happens? If y is equal to 0, the equation will be reduced to x is equal to plus or minus a. Just observe this. When this is 0, cross multiply this, then you'll get plus or minus b by root of a square minus x square is 0. Then when you send b to this side, root of a square minus x square becomes 0. Then square root gets cancelled, a square will be equal to x square. That means you will get x is equal to plus or minus a. This implies the curve is intersecting x axis at two points, that is a is equal to a comma 0 and a dash is equal to minus a comma 0. Therefore, we can say a dash, length of a dash is equal to 2a. Length of a dash is equal to 2a when we say that is forming the axis of the parabola. What axis? That we will discuss after a few points, right? Now, if we take this formula x is equal to plus or minus a by b root of b square minus y square, and if we take x is equal to 0, like how we have taken y equal to 0, then we will have it as y is equal to plus or minus b. Now, this means that the curve is intersecting y-axis at two different points. The two points what we have will be 0, comma b and 0, comma minus b. That means b, b dash is nothing but 2b. Now, The curve lies inside the rectangle bounded by the lines x is equal to a and minus a, y is equal to b and minus b. So you will have the curve like this, or the conic, what we are taking, the ellipse with the coordinate axis x, x dash and y, y dash. Okay. Of course, it has got two foci, that is s and s dash. A and a dash are the vertices. I'm sure that you are observing the diagram, right? Then this is the line which is passing through A. What we got it as x is equal to A, and this is x is equal to minus A. Then we got y is equal to B and y is equal to minus B. So the four lines which are surrounding this ellipse, they are forming a rectangle. That means the ellipse is bounded by these four lines. These four lines are represented with x equal to a, x equal to minus a, x is y is equal to b and y is equal to minus b. Now this ellipse has got center as c. Now when center is c, the coordinates of the center is 0 comma 0. Now any chord which is passing through the center of this ellipse will be bisected at the center, children. The center will be bisecting the chord. Bisecting, the chord will be divided into two equal parts. So we can conclude saying, any chord through C 0 comma 0 of the ellipse is bisected at the center. And the center of an ellipse is defined as the point of intersection of its axis of symmetry. Symmetry, generally, when you are when a line is dividing a geometrical figure into two equal or two mirror images, then that is nothing but the symmetrical division, and that line will be called as symmetric line, right? Now here the center of an ellipse is defined as point of intersection of the axis of symmetry. Now what are the axis you are taking here? The major axis and the minor axis of the ellipse. Now what is this major axis and minor axis? See, the line segment a dash and b dash, just now we have seen the lengths of these two are 2a and 2b, isn't it? Now these are nothing but the axis of the ellipse. Now if the value of a is greater than b, then a dash will be considered as the major axis and b dash will be taken as minor axis. Now suppose if a is less than b, then it becomes vice versa. That means a dash becomes the minor axis and b dash will become the major axis. Now children, there are various forms of ellipse. Okay, one form what we have seen is the standard form. This is the standard form what we have seen with center 0 comma 0, right? Now we will see a comparative study of the conjugate of the standard form. This is the conjugate form of the standard form of ellipse. Okay, now hope that you are able to see the difference between both, right? Now we will try to distinguish what exactly how they are differing. Now equation of the ellipse, what we have seen is x square by a square plus y square by b square equal to 1. That means a is greater than 0 for the standard form. This we have ensured, isn't it? When we have derived the standard form of the ellipse. Now, in the case of its conjugate form, you will have the same equation, but only the condition is a will be less than b. Okay. Now, here, since we are taking the center as the origin itself, so the center of the standard form will be 0 comma 0. And what are the vertices here, children? A dash are the vertices on the major axis, isn't it? So we will take them as we have taken it as a comma 0 and minus a comma 0. So the vertices we will define them as plus or minus a comma 0. Now in the second, the conjugate form, where we have it as 0 comma 0 as the center, and here the major axis is changing to b dash. Therefore, the vertices will be considered as plus or 0 comma plus or minus b. Okay. Now, in the first case, in the standard form, the foci, we have taken it as S and S dash, isn't it? So what is S? AE comma 0 that we have derived, and S dash we have taken it as minus AE comma 0, isn't it? The same thing we are taking here. But in the conjugate form, look at this. Where are the foci? They are on the y-axis, isn't it? So of course, your x coordinate will become 0. Therefore, 0 comma plus or minus BE will give you the foci of the ellipse in the conjugate form. Now, not only that, you need to know certain important terminology in this, and all, of course, their values and the equations. Now, length of the major axis. Major axis here in this case is AA dash. Length of AA dash, we have seen it as 2A. And equation of the major axis, this is the major axis, which is lying on the X axis itself here. So its equation will be Y equal to 0. And in this case, in the conjugate form, major axis is BB dash. Therefore, length will be 2B. And of course, BB dash is on the Y axis. Therefore, its equation is X equal to 0. Then length of the minor axis, length of the minor axis will be taken as 2B. In this case, isn't it? This is the minor axis. BB dash is minor axis here. Here AA dash is the minor axis, right? So length of the minor axis here is 2B, and its equation will be given by X equal to 0. And likewise, in the conjugate form, you have length of the minor axis as 2A, and its equation is Y equal to 0. Now, distance between the vertices. Now, these are the two vertices what you're taking in this standard form. So, AA dash will be equal to 2A. And here in this case, BB dash will be equal to 2B. Okay. Now, few more concepts you need to know, children. Eccentricity. Eccentricity can be calculated for the standard form and of course for the conjugate form of the ellipse also by the formula root of a square minus b square by a square and root of b square minus a square by b square when you have a value less than b. Right? Now length of the lattice rectum. What is lattice rectum? It is a focal chord perpendicular to the axis of the ellipse, isn't it? So length of the lattice rectum for the standard form will be given by 2b square by a, and for its conjugate form as 2a square by b. Then feet of the directrices, directrices in this case, it is z here in this, isn't it? So that will be given by plus or minus a by e comma 0, and here it is 0 comma plus or minus b by e. Now, children, this we have already seen in the standard form when we were deriving. This is the first value what we have calculated in the standard form. Now, when I say the various forms of an ellipse, we have seen the standard form of the ellipse and also its conjugate form when we have center as 0, 0. But in your first year, we have seen we can also shift the center or the origin to some other point, isn't it? Now, when the origin or when the center of the ellipse is shifted to some other point, then how the equation of the ellipse varies, that we will again see with a comparative study. Now, this is the origin what we have, but the center of the ellipse is not origin now, it is shifted to some other point. Okay, then in this case, how the values or the equations, what we have seen in the previous case, change. And not only that, with center some h comma k, we are seeing the conjugate form of the ellipse also. Okay. Now let us start with equation of the ellipse, children. In the case of the center other than 0 comma 0, that other than 0 comma 0, that point we are taking it as h comma k. So the equation will be x minus h whole square by a square plus y minus k whole square by b square equal to 1. And here we are taking a is greater than b. That means a dash will be the major axis and b dash will be the minor axis. Okay, please keep this in mind. Then h minus x whole square by a square plus y minus k whole square by b square equal to 1 when you take a less than b. This is for the conjugate form when we have center other than the origin. Okay, then the center, as I was mentioning, we are taking it as some h comma k, right? Then in this case, vertices also changes, isn't it? Vertical, the vertices will be given by h plus r minus a comma k. And in the conjugate form, the center will be h comma k, but the vertices will be h comma k plus r minus b. Right? Now, what is this k plus r minus b, children? That means the point B will have h comma k plus b, and b dash will be h comma k minus b. That is the meaning here. And same thing applies over here also. Okay? Now, let us see what will be the coordinates of the foci. S and S dash. So S and S dash will be given by H plus R minus AE comma K for the, the standard form with some center H comma K, and right in the conjugate form, you have H comma K plus R minus BE, right? And likewise, we will see what is length of major axis here. Length of major axis will be taken as 2a, and the equation will be given by y is equal to k, because the line what you are taking as the major axis is parallel to the x-axis. Previously it was on the x-axis itself, right? So I want you to observe this particular point. And then here the length of the major axis will be 2b, and guess what will be the equation of major axis here? It should be x is equal to h, right? Okay, then length of the minor axis, in the first case it will be 2b, and its equation will be x is equal to h, and length of the minor axis here it will be 2a, and its equation will be y is equal to k. Then distance between the vertices, it will be given by a dash is equal to 2a and b dash is equal to 2b. Not only this, children, we need to know what will be the eccentricity. Eccentricity will be given by the same formula what we have seen previously, that is root of a square minus b square by a square and root of b square minus a square by b square only. There is no change in this. And you can also observe length of the lattice rectum will not change. It will be same 2b square by a and 2a square by b. Then feet of the directrices. Feet of the directrices will be given by h plus or minus a by e comma k and h comma k plus or minus b by e. I want you to just go through these slides and try to differentiate what exactly is changing in the standard form and its conjugate form. And when the axis is changing, that means instead of taking coordinate axis x and y, and the origin is shifted to some other point, some h comma k, the center of the ellipse is shifted to h comma k. Okay, children. Now on this basic concept, what we have seen, we will see one or two problems so that the concept will be clear. Now you have find the equation of the ellipse with focus at 1 comma minus 1 and eccentricity 2 by 3. Its directrix is given as x plus y plus 2 equal to 0. Now you are given with a focus, that is s is minus 1, 1 comma minus 1, eccentricity is given as 2 by 3, directrix is given as x plus y plus 2 equal to 0. Now we will, at random, we'll pick a point on the ellipse and we'll say that point to be P x1 comma y1. So we'll say let P x1 comma y1 be a point on the ellipse. Then according to the basic condition, what we have started with, the derivation of equation of an ellipse, SP is equal to E into PM. We will start calculating equation of the ellipse. We know S, we know P, we know E, and we also know what is PM, isn't it? So we'll take this as root of X1 minus 1. What is this, children, what we are taking here? This is nothing but the distance formula, right? So root of x1 minus 1 whole square plus y1 plus 1 whole square, because you have a minus 1 over here, right? This is equal to, you have the value of E as 2 by 3. And this is the perpendicular distance what you're taking, right? So you will take it as mod of x1 plus y1 plus 2 by root of 1 square plus 1 square. This is the perpendicular distance formula what you have seen in the straight lines topic of your first year, right? Now we will take this as root of x1 minus 1 whole square plus y1 plus 1 whole square is equal to 2 by 3 into mod of x1 plus y1 plus 2 divided by 1 plus 1, which is 2, under root. So root 2. Got it? Now the previous equation, what we got, we are squaring it. When we square 2 by 3, you are getting it as 4 by 9. And of course, we are squaring mod of x1 plus y1 plus 2 and also root 2 whole square, which is becoming 2. Then this 2 and 4, they get cancelled, children. Then go for cross multiplication and simplify this. So you have it as 9 into x1 minus 1 whole square plus y1 plus 1 whole square. This is equal to 2 into, you're left with 2, isn't it? 2 ones and 2 twos. So 2 into x1 plus y1 plus 2 whole square. Now we will expand this. This implies 9 into x1 square minus 2x1. This is a minus b whole square form, isn't it? So x1 square minus 2x1 plus 1 plus y1 square plus 2y1 plus 1, which is equal to 2 into, this is a plus b plus c whole square form. So a square, that is x1 square plus y1 square plus 2 square, which is 4, plus 2x1 y1 plus 2y1 into 2 plus 2 into 2 plus into x1. Right? We will simplify it further. You will have 1 plus 1, 2 here in this bracket. That's all you can simplify in this left hand side bracket. And here, of course, this is 4y1, 2 into 2, 4y1 and 4x1. That we will write. Of course, when you are writing this, please make sure that every time when you are simplifying, you arrange them according to the order of powers, in the descending order of powers. So what did we get here? X1 square plus y1 square minus 2x1 plus 2y1 plus 2. And here you have x1 square plus y1 square plus 2x1 y1 plus 4x1. Then you have 4y1 plus 4. All right. Then we will just write the same step over here. Right, then multiply 9 with all the terms which are there in the bracket. So 9x1 square plus 9y1 square minus 18x1 plus 18y1 plus 9 into 2, 18 minus 2x1 square. Why this is minus? Because I am taking all these terms to the other side. Okay, so minus 2y1 square minus 4x1 y1 minus 8x1 minus 8y1 minus 8, which is equal to 0. Now 9x1 square minus 2x1 square is 7x1 square, and 9y1 square minus 2y1 square is 7y1 square minus 18x1 minus 18x1 minus 8x1, it becomes minus 26x1. Then 18y1 minus 8y1, which is nothing but 10y1. 18 minus 8, which is 10. So you will get it as 7x1 square minus 4x1y1 plus 7y1 square minus 2 minus 26x1 plus 10y1 plus 10 equal to 0. Right? Now you are taking a point Px1 comma y1 at random. So we will try to write in the general form, like how you wrote your ellipse concept in the general form as the last step, isn't it? So therefore equation of the ellipse will be given by 7x square minus 4xy plus 7y square minus 26x plus 10y plus 10 equal to 0. Okay, so this is the equation of the ellipse which we are calculating from the basic formula SP is equal to E into PM. We will also see one more problem, children. Find the equation of the ellipse in the standard form whose distance between foci is 2 and length of the lattice rectum is 15 by 2. Length of the lattice rectum. Just now we have seen all the formulae, isn't it? So we'll see the solution, children. You are given that length of the lattice rectum is 15 by 2. What is length of the lattice rectum? It is given by the formula, yes, 2b square by a. So 2b square by a is equal to 15 by 2. And this is the diagram what we have for an ellipse. These are the coordinates how we take. S and S dash will be given by AE comma 0 and minus AE comma 0. And, excuse me, A is equal to A comma 0 and A dash is equal to minus A comma 0 are the vertices of the ellipse, right? Now, distance between the foci when we take, the distance should be between these two points. That means S S dash is given as 2. S S dash when you take, right? This is the center 0 comma 0. 0 comma 0 to this point is AE. 0 comma 0 to this point, the distance is again AE. AE plus AE gives you 2 AE. Therefore, S S dash will be 2 AE, which is equal to 2. From this, we can conclude that AE is equal to 1 by cancelling 2 on either sides. Now, we have seen one formula when we were deriving the ellipse equation, children. What is it? A square into 1 minus E square is B square, isn't it? We have taken one real value B, which is greater than 0. You remember that, what we have taken in the proof, right? So, we will take A square into 1 minus E square is equal to B square. Therefore, 2B square by A instead of B square, we can replace it with A square into 1 minus E square. Instead of B square, we are writing A square into 1 minus E square. But what is this 2B square by A? The value is given to us as 15 by 2. Right? Now, A square minus, look at this, A square into 1 is A square minus A square into E square by A. What is happening to this 2? This 2 we are getting here. We are writing it as 15 by 4. Okay. Now, you know AE is equal to 1. When AE is equal to 1, what should be A square, E square? It is also equal to 1. Isn't it? So, instead of A square, E square, we will just write it as 1. So, you will have it as A square minus 1 by A is equal to 15 by 4. Now, go for cross multiplication. Then you will have it as 4A square minus 15A minus 4 is equal to 0. Now, did you recollect anything by looking at this equation? I was explaining this type of equations when I've taken quadratic expressions topic in your 2A, isn't it? It is representing a quadratic equation in the variable A, right? So, we will just calculate what are the values of A here. So, 4A square minus 15A minus 4 is equal to 0. Then, we will try to factorize this by taking 15A as minus 16A plus A. Then from the first two terms, you can take 4A common. Then you'll have A minus 4. And from these two terms, if you take one common, then you'll get A minus 4 is equal to 0. Then from first and the second terms, if you take A minus 4 equal to 0, you'll have A minus 4 into 4A plus 1 is equal to 0. That means the value of A will be 4 and minus 1 by 4. Right? So, we got the value of A. Once we get the value of A, just calculate what is A square. A square is 16. Right? Then what is B square? B square, we are taking it as A square into 1 minus E square. So, substitute the values, whatever you know, children. Then you will have it as b square is equal to 16 into 1 minus 1 by 16. Right? Then you will have it as b square is equal to 16 into 15 by 16. That means b square is equal to 15. Therefore, equation of the ellipse will be given by x square by 16 plus y square by 15 is equal to 1. Right? I'm sure that you are able to understand this calculation. And these are the two problems which will give you a better idea of what we have seen in the standard form of the ellipse. Now, having learned these two, I would like to leave two questions as a practice session for you. I want you to try out these two problems. And wherever you find it difficult, I want you to revisit the channel and try to see the video. And I'm very sure that you will not have any doubts in that case. Okay? Thank you.
Thank you, Ushasri madam. Thank you very much for your elaborate session. Children, this topic, ellipse, which was dealt by Ushasri madam, is very important. Go through again and again the video and write down your notes. Thank you once again.
Thank you, madam.